Hey everybody, Chris here from CodePen. I want to show you how privacy works at CodePen because it's one of those things that we offer. It's actually a pro feature. I'm logged in here under myself and I'm a pro user, so I can do this. I'm going to go create pen, and then you'll notice as a pro user, I can just hit save as private, which is a button that's not there if you're a free user. So I see I have this blinking green cursor here too. Let me just go turn off Vim mode. I was testing something and I don't know Vim very well. Anyway, I'm just going to click it, and I can save it totally empty if I want, and I could say like, H1, this is my private pen, yes, and I'll just do this. Now, I can make anything. I can use the full feature set of CodePen to do anything. There's no difference between a private pen and a public pen is like as far as features go or anything like that. But why would I make it private to begin with, and what does private mean? I might make it private because, I mean, it means what the word private means. It means that nobody can see this except for me, or unless I explicitly share that with them. And it does that by obscurity in a way. Look at this URL. This is like scientifically unguessable. And so it's hidden from the UI of CodePen. Like if I were to start like an incognito window or something and go to codepen.io and even like go to my profile, which is something that you can do in when you make public pens on CodePen, your profile showcases those public pens. So I could look at recently created pens by myself. And notice this one isn't there. If this was public, it would be there. Now for a second, just to illustrate that, I'll set it to be public and I'll change that. Now people can like come across this and, you know, and search it and find it on CodePen. But as soon as you've made that private, that's no longer the case. So I can refresh that and it's gone away. Now people can't find it. They can't guess it. If I were to share this or like tweet it or share it on Facebook or something, that URL will work and people can come to this pen. But as long as you don't do that, it's private. It's a private pen. It won't show up in CodePen search, for example. It won't show up in Google search because we tell Google to not index any private pens like that. But I could still find it. Like I can look for this particular string. Let's say I've made this 6 months ago and now I'm trying to find it again. I could go to my dashboard and my dashboard, because I'm logged in as myself, will show it. I can say view filter all, or I could say, well, only show me public pens or only show me private pens only. And you'll see stuff in there that's scoped in that way. But I could search as well. This is my private pen. I'd say I remember that about the pen. CodePen search will turn it up for you. So pretty cool, really. That's what privacy is. And it's not just pens. It's all of the types of content on CodePen entirely. So let's say I wanted to write a post. I could say my private post with some content in it. I can just toggle it over to private, publish it, and I will have if I view it, I'll have this one of these very long URLs that's kind of unguessable. So I could send that to my colleagues for something to read. You know, it's like a really easy place to just like publish some words and have people see it with kind of nice free formatting and comment threads with email notifications and all that stuff. Now, Google's not going to run across this. It's not going to show up in web search or CodePen search in any way. It's totally isolated from the rest of the world of CodePen. But I could just flip it back on. So I could make a private pen for client work because I want to show something to a client, some widget that I'm working on, and have only them see it, but nobody else. It's not part of the public world of CodePen. That's why I might use private pens. Or I'm working on it and I intend to make it public, but I want somebody else to see it later. You know, like I just want, you know, it to be finished before anybody else sees it. You can do that kind of thing. Or if it's just a little throwaway something and you just never want it to be public and I just don't really care, it's just a private thing, that's fine. You could have a CodePen account in which every single thing that you do is private because you just don't care for it to be public. That's fine. You can do whatever you want, but that ability to make things private is a pro feature. Works the same exact way for projects, of course. We say unlimited privacy. In fact, we have a landing page that describes privacy. And we say it's unlimited privacy because you have unlimited pens. There's no limit to how many pens that you can make or posts or collections on CodePen. Projects are limited in number of them, but they're unlimited in that as many projects as you can make is as many of them as could be private. So no limits that way. The only thing that's worth mentioning here that's a little bit unique, I'm going to say my private collection, is how privacy works with collections. So I don't even need one. I'm going to make it private. So my private collection was created. Now I could find it in any number of ways. For example, I could explore collections and go to my collections and see them, although I think it might be only showing me public ones, which kind of makes sense. Or it might not be showing it because there's nothing in it yet. My private collections has no things in it yet. You can see it has a lock here because it's private. Now, what happens with collections are collections of pens at the moment. Maybe someday they'll have more stuff in them. But let's say I would add my private pen to my private collection. Well, let's go to my dashboard and look at pens, and I'll look for that private pen and I'll add it to the collection, my private collection. Now that's just beyond the screen there. The drop-down menu is pretty long because I have lots of collections because they're unlimited. It has a little lock there too. So now I've added it to that collection. So I'll go to my collections. My private collection will have one pen in it now that I can see. And I can see it because I'm logged in as myself. But if I go with an incognito window for this collection that's private, you'll still see the pen there. Now I wouldn't if the collection was public. So it's kind of like follow my logic here for a moment. If I open this collection and edit the collection to make it public and save it and then refresh this, like I'm looking at it as like an anonymous user now, you won't see the pen in there. So it's like you can make public collections and put all kinds of anything you want in there, public pens, private pens, and whatever. And the only thing you'll see there when you're anonymous and a public collection is public work. Because you don't want to, if it's public, this collection is findable publicly. So we wanted to make sure that other public stuff can be seen in there. But if you put something private in there, that won't show up because anybody can find a public collection. But as soon as you make the collection private, which I'm going to do here, then it's like, well, the collection's already private, so it's okay to show private things within it. So it's like that on purpose. And it's like that because you might be like, well, I'm making like five things for a client. I'm going to make five private pens and I'm going to put those private pens in a private collection. And then I'm going to share with my client the collection. So they have one URL where they can see all the stuff in here, but it's all private still and they can still see it. So that's pretty cool. So every type of content on CodePen can be private: posts, pens, collections, projects. And you can make, anything that you can make private. It's unlimited and it's all a pro feature. So that's the explanation of it. Let us know if you have any questions.